So in this video, I think it's going to be all about photographing in the rain and coming away with hopefully something successful. Because right now I'm in the Faroe Islands, and as per reputation, the weather is gray and moody and rainy. And as you can see here, I'm in this beautiful scene. So I'm very, very close to Tórshavn, the capital of the Faroe Islands. It's literally just here. And right now I'm looking south. There's supposedly an island out here called Nólsoy. But right now I have a rain shower coming in from south and moving this way here into the scene. So it's going to hit me very, very soon. Or maybe it will just go around me. I'm not entirely sure just yet. Loads of mood, seagulls flying around, unruly sea, all the good stuff that we love. So the first thing you want to make sure when you're photographing in the rain is that you can actually endure the rain. So for the most part, I would recommend people to put on some rain clothing. Right now I have my Arctic jacket on, and it's not super good for rain. However, the hotel is just up here, so, and this is like the only location I'm going to shoot. So I think it will be fine. A little wet, but fine. But I have put on my rain pants. So if you're out for the entire day, simply be sure to bring on rain clothing so you can actually endure being out in this kind of weather. Because there's nothing worse than being wet and trying to photograph, and it all just is a little bit miserable because you're wet. Then you don't get the photographs that you actually want. And after all, that's why we're out photographing, is to get good photos. So the rain is really coming in now. It is of course also important to have some gear that is weather resistant. Excuse me if there's too much wind noise right now. I hope there's not, because I'm getting it full frontal here. So it's important to also have some gear that can actually endure the weather and be somewhat weather, water, dust resistant. I'm on my Sony a7 R3. It's not the best camera in the world for this, but for rain, it has not really failed on me. Now, the Sony cameras can be a little bit problematic when shooting in the rain because it has this hot shoe error. So I've tried to like cover it up, but it's a little bit of a problem shooting with these specific cameras. I don't think Nikon, Canon, or some of the other brands has that issue. Hopefully Sony will fix it in the future. Right now it's just a pain in the butt. But some people, they really don't like to have their like $3,000 camera out in the rain, and it's completely natural. Just know that most of the professional cameras, they are made to be able to endure most like light rain. Not super heavy rain, just go in, don't take it into a waterfall or drop it in the stream or something like that. But rain like this, they should be fine for the most part. Totally not my responsibility if you wreck your camera, but for me, I haven't had issues with rain water with my cameras. It is of course the same thing with lenses. They can also be more or less weather resistant. Obviously, go for the lenses that are weather resistant. So there are different strategies to photograph in the rain, whether you want to just have a single exposure or you're okay with blending several different exposures together. I'm not entirely sure what I'm going to do here, but my idea is to blend several different exposures together because, after all, this is a seascape scene. So I want to have, like, you know, the optimal wave hitting some rock place. And as you can see here, I also expect to have myself standing down there. So have some waves hitting out here when it like pumps up, and maybe also over here. That would look rather good. I also have my foreground that leads down to where I'm standing, and I'm looking into the background and into the island right here, Nólsoy. Have a little boat coming in out here. I may want to include that in the photo too. And of course, the showers keep coming in and the clouds change from time to time. You can, of course, also get it all in one shot if you want to, but I personally have no problem blending different shots together, especially not when it's at the same location and it's just a little bit over time. And of course, if you want to know even more about how I think composition in landscape photography, be sure to get my two ebooks. I go through all of the different tools I use, how I think with visual flow, with balance of the photo, how to show scale and motion, all the things you will need to take really, really great landscape photos. So yeah, there are links to them down in the description. Thank you to all of you who have already got them. I super appreciate all the 5-star reviews, all the very, very kind emails I get from you in regard to how you use the ebooks and also how much you enjoy them and how much you learn from them. So thank you so much. Links in the description. And yeah, let's move on and get this shot done because this is cold. So first and foremost, you want to have some settings that are optimal for the amount of light that you are working in right now. Since I'm shooting wide angle at around 30 millimeter, zoomed a little bit into the scene here with my 16-35, I find that f11 is enough to get the entire scene in focus. I go to ISO 320, so a little bit up, as to have a shutter speed which is a little bit faster. So right now I'm on 1/115th of a second. And that works well to photograph the waves out there in the background. They're not really smoothed that much out because they're so far away. Now, if you want to have it all in one exposure, how I typically photograph in rain, if I have rain coming in onto my sensor, is that I, in this case, always shoot in manual mode. I often shoot in aperture priority, but right here I have to shoot in manual mode. And that is because I use a lens cloth. I put the camera on 2-second timer. So I press my shutter button, 2 seconds go by, and then I get the shot. Now, using my lens cloth, I cover up the lens. I just wipe the lens and then I cover it up. So I hit the shutter. See here, just put it in 2-second timer. So I hit the shutter, I wipe the lens, and then I remove, and then it takes the shot. And that should give me a very clean photo without any droplets or rain particles on the sensor. So that is for like one exposure, if I shoot one exposure in conditions like this. So very fast to sum up, if you didn't hear it because of the wind noise, I find my composition, I put in the optimal settings that I need to use, then I put the camera into 2-second timer while being on the tripod, of course, and then I hit the shutter, wipe the front of the lens, and then within those 2 seconds I also remove the lens cloth. And that's how I get the vast majority of my photos in rain. Now, in this particular case here, there's also another strategy, and that is because everything is changing so much and I want to have myself in the scene. So what I'm going to do then, I'm going to blend a lot of different exposures, a so-called time blending. I'm going to do that in Photoshop, and I show that in my time blending tutorial. There's a link down in the description. And there's a seagull flying around, that's why I'm getting a little bit distracted and looking out on the sea all the time. So when I want several different exposures, I more or less do exactly the same thing as just before. However, in the shot where I want to be in myself, I put my camera, as you can see here. I have put into my functions menu my intervalometer. So I just put that one on. And to begin with, there is a 30-second delay. And then it takes a shot every 6 seconds. So I just hit the shutter. And then you can see it's counting down from 30 seconds. I just wipe off the lens, and then I simply just walk into the scene. So when I have the shot where I've been walking into the scene, then I can just blend that shot together with some of the more optimal photos, and in that way I get all the best stuff from the same scene I've been shooting. You may ask in regard to water droplets on the camera front lens here while taking those photos, and that is next to nearly impossible to avoid. Obviously, depending on how much water is in the air and how much the wind is blowing and how long you're in the scene and how far away you are, then you may get the shot just with a little less contrast because all the water comes onto the front lens, and it may just like smear out the photo a little bit or remove a little bit of the contrast. In this particular case, it's not a big deal. You will have to take it case by case, photo by photo, whether it's possible to even get that photo. But again, it's not a huge deal today in this particular scene here. Another thing that's also super important when you do time blending and when you photograph, as I photograph right now, where I'm not necessarily changing the settings but taking a lot of different photos, is that you put your camera into manual focus. You don't want to refocus after each photo. You need to first focus your camera, and then you have to keep that focus all the way through because it makes it so much easier to blend the photos together in Photoshop afterwards. But yeah, this is basically it. I will just stand here, collect a few more photos with some beautiful waves, wave action along the coast, and then I can blend it all together in Photoshop, and yeah, it should look really, really, really epic. To say other than I absolutely love how this photo turned out. So moody, so ominous, so dramatic, and it has that dark, unfathomable and eerie feeling that the sea can bring in conditions like this. I actually ended up blending 10 photos together as to get the seagulls right, the small ship in the background and the waves crashing against the rocks. I also decided to use a background where the island of Nolsoy is partly hidden behind the rain as to add more depth and especially more mystery into the photo. Be sure to get my ebook on composition if you want to learn even more about that. Check out my big post-processing course, Photoshop for Landscape Photographers, where I share everything I know about Photoshop and how to edit photos. And if you want a standalone tutorial on how to make time blends, I have that one too. There are coupons available for the tutorials in the description of this video to save a bit of money. I hope you enjoyed this video, learned a lot, and as always, I highly appreciate both a like and a comment.